Hi everyone, my name is Fidelis and I am so happy and so glad to be having this moment and session with you. I have been contacted many times. I know a lot of my friends who are trying to apply for the Atlas Core Fellowship. I have been on my neck. Some have been calling me, some sent me a lot of texts, and you know who you are. I won't mention names, but I've been getting a lot of calls, a lot of texts, a lot of messages, and you know, there is so much need for people to apply for this and succeed. This is a very, very prestigious program, and if you're very passionate about, you know, social impact at the global scale, Atlas Core is the best place for you to be. If you want to learn the best leadership models and skills and abilities and workplace efficiency within the nonprofit sector, Atlas Core has everything you need. Atlas Core is also very, it's more like a talent recruitment nonprofit model that, you know, gets people from all over the world, and not just any kind of people, all right? People that are social impact leaders, people doing things in their communities, people already working within a sector and doing something around social impact and social development. So if you are doing one or two things around these places, you might probably be a very good fit for the Atlas Core program. I would say that for anyone who is ready to be part and parcel of the Atlas Core family, I am here for you, okay? I will be helping you with answers, with tips, with strategies on how best to answer those specific questions. I would also be taking you on a journey on the questions themselves, each of the questions one after the other, and we'll be analyzing it quickly. We're not going to spend so much time trying to talk so much about Atlas Core. Please go to the website if you want to know more about the thing you're interested in. So if you're interested in it, then let's do this together. So just a quick set of tips before I go straight into the application proper. I know that most of you people, especially young people who are applying for this, are feeling discouraged already. Please, I want you to know that do not be discouraged. And this is why. I applied for the fellowship about two times before I got into it for the third time. All right. So if you have gotten a rejection mail, if you've gotten any mail saying that we are sorry, we regret to inform you that you have not been selected for this, don't be discouraged. Okay. Don't be discouraged, because the beauty about the program is that, fellows are taken every 4 months, all right? So it's not like 1 year thing. So there's one now that has just been open for October, and I think it's closing in November 3rd. That's for those who will be coming in for April 2020 next year. And I think there's another set for August, and there's another set for October. So there are always cohorts to be taken every time of the year. So don't be discouraged. If you have gotten a rejection mail, please go back to the application and start again. When I did mine in 2017, I applied the first time. I didn't even get to stage two. From the first stage, just let me, dude, we are very sorry. We do not think your profile qualifies for the exact kind of specs that we're looking for. Please consider maybe reapplying or doing this again next year. All right. And you know, I will share this on my timeline. I don't take no for an answer. So I reapplied again, and I think I got to the second stage and I got a rejection mail. This time around, I wasn't feeling too good about the messages anymore. My morale was down, you know, and all of that. So I had to start again. So by the third time I applied, now I have learned a little about how the program works, what the specific tips are. In 3 months, and I'm saying this frankly, in 3 months, I got into the program. I went from the first phase, which had to do with your biography, to the next phase, which had to do with the long essays, your employment history, your skill sets, your recommendations. You know, that particular form, I'm sure some of you have been there, but for those of you that are not there yet, you get there. That long form, I did it when I submitted. In less than about 3 weeks or 2 weeks, I got another information. They invited me for the second, the third stage, which is, you know, the interview with Atlas Core, which I scaled through. And finally, I had a final interview with the host organization. So the program is really that structured. You have the first one where you talk about your biography and who you are and what you do. Then the next stage has to do, you'll be invited if you qualify, if they assess your biography, then it takes you to the next stage. The next stage is what basically you have all your answers around your long essays, short essays, your descriptions. That second part is actually the part where you have to sell yourself. All right. Then the third part is where you're invited for an interview. You have an interview with Atlas Core, and if you qualify for that stage, you get to the final interview with the host organization that will be hosting you for the 1 year or 1 year and 6 months, you know, depending. So you're very lucky if watching this video right now, and I want you to please share this information with so many people out there. I would try to do my best to talk about the things that made me succeed, all right? I will talk about the things, the tips that worked for me and worked for many other of my fellows that I've had the opportunity to have this conversation with. I've been speaking with a couple of the fellows, and there are just some consistent things that we all did that made us really succeed, all right? So these are the things I really want to share with you if you are willing to be part and parcel of this conversation, all right? Okay, so let me quickly say here now that one thing is very, very important, okay? This program is basically for people that are interested in having an experience in the US on development and on leadership, all right? You are given what I call a first-class professional development training that helps you do what you already do in your community, whatever part of the world that you are. It gives you the specific skill sets, gives you the experience, gives you the exposure, gives you the networks to learn on the job, and also to be able to get all of these things and replicate them back once you get back to your country or to your community. All right, so it is not a very conventional kind of fellowship. It is one of the best fellowships that you can ever be on. So I would suggest that if you are really thinking about this, you know, please take it seriously. It's not something you want to joke with. For me as a person, I have learned so much, and I know I have a lot to learn. You'll be surprised what has happened in between these 2 years called my head. All right, I have learned so much. I'm learning so much in the course of this. So I would say that please take the shot, all right? If you don't get to hit, try it again, all right? Keep throwing until you get the bull's eye, because you will. There's something I always tell people and tell my friends and my community of people that I work with. If you never give up, life would not give up on you. So just keep doing what you have to do to make sure that you get the best thing. However, information is power, all right? The difference between the people who are succeeding and the people who are not succeeding, people say it is luck, it is chance, but I think the difference is some good knowledge of specific kind of information coupled with hard work, all right? So you need the right kind of information to guide you, then you back it up with hard work, and I can guarantee you that success will be very attainable. So the first set of things I want to give you now is this. Atlas Core oftentimes focuses on many areas, but there are four important areas she focuses on whenever she's recruiting nonprofit leaders or social impact leaders or social change leaders from all over the world. The first part, which I had to even write, is this. If you're working around communications, okay, you are likely going to be a very good candidate. If you're working around project management or program management, you are likely going to be a very good candidate for this application and this fellowship. If you're also working around monitoring and evaluation, you're likely going to be a very good candidate. And finally, if you're working around tech, okay, we are likely going to be a very good candidate. Whatever skill set, whatever ideas, whatever knowledge that you're going to be putting in the application, if you try to capture one of this and specify clearly how you are good in any of this part, I suspect that you'll be a very good candidate for the program, all right? I want to share this with you. When I applied, I leveraged more on project management and capacity development. But I emphasized so much on the projects I've done, how I did them, what the results were, what the metrics were. And I linked it up to my capacity development project, leadership development project, working with young people, helping communities with disabilities, all of those things. I tried to tell my story in a way that leveraged so much on project management. So that's why I said those four areas are areas that you should focus on. Choose one of them and tell your story in that regard. Second tip I have for you is be authentic, all right? Be authentic when you tell your story. Tell your story from the heart. And why I say this is this: don't cook up ideas. Don't cook up things you have not done. Don't, you know, because somehow you're still going to go through a couple of interviews. And in those interviews, you would have to demonstrate exceptionally that you have actually done those things. there are metrics to determine whether or not you did this thing. So what I always tell people is, if you worked with a community and empowered just 50 people, state it, all right? Say that you worked, you should be proud of it, by the way. It doesn't matter whether or not they reckon with it. You should be proud of what you've done. State it how you did it, all right? Emphasize the power of those impacts. And more importantly, you know, think about the ripple effect of some of the things that you have done on the community. So I will say that tell your story as my first very, you know, straight tip. Then the next one is be authentic. When you answer these things, answer them authentically, all right? Say them from the heart. I would suggest that you don't try to lie. You know, I know this is something we hear all the time, but there are experts in this review process, and trust me, lies are easy to detect. Okay, so the first part of your application will talk about, you know, yourself and what it is you want to do, your name, your biography, and, you know, your specific details. That biography is like the thing that will determine whether or not you're going to the next stage. All right. So in that biography, if you're taking an aspect of communication, please let your biography identify, specify, and clarify that you're a communications expert. Okay. Maybe you're into social media advocacy, you're into journalism, you're into whatever it is you're doing. Make sure that your biography, you know, clarifies and leverages. You are able to tell that you are an expert in that particular area that you are applying. If you are going to be telling a story around project management, all right, let your biography be a lot of that, all right? My name is this, I have 8 years in project management. State it clearly, don't waste time, all right? Then go ahead and talk about the specific skill sets you have and all of that, what kind of awards you got in that area. If you are going to be talking about monitoring and evaluation, state that clearly. This is a one in a million advice, all right? So hopefully that takes you to the next stage. It's going to talk about the stage two. The stage two is where you have the long form and you have to fill. And I'm sure that's where most of us seem to have a little one or two challenges here and there, okay? And it says here that you have a couple of things to fill, but there's a part that has to do with your employment history. Under the employment history, try to state clearly that your positions are positions in line with the specific thing you want to apply for. Okay, so if you're applying the project management line, emphasize the work that you have done in this area, you know, the employment history around this, and you know, that in itself could help you clarify a couple of things and make things even a lot better. Okay, need a minimum of 2 years work experience, so if you can take care of that and you know, tell them exactly how you've done it and the kind of impact you've made in the course of doing it. Excellent. So once you're able to, you know, clarify in your employment history that you have some of the skills that is needed, then you're good to go. The next part is the skills, basically. So you have already specific kind of skills that, you know, is being looked out for. I would say choose the ones that seem to connect more with the kind of probably thing you're putting. If you're writing on communication, on project management, choose the specific skills that are in line with that. There's a part that also talked about social issues, all right? Pick those issues that are in line with that thing. I always say this, your application is like a story, all right? There's always the introduction, there is the main body, and there's the conclusion. But there is one thing that connects the whole application, all right? Let it be known that you are an expert in that thing you said you are. So if you're choosing anything, make sure that it is in line. It is in line, it is in line. Your short essays basically is to emphasize exactly some of the things you've said before, all right? But I know that when you tell and analyze and talk about why you chose those social issues or those skill sets, you have to demonstrate clearly that you know what you're doing. Think about it like this. You're going for a job interview, and when you go for a job interview, what you need to do is you want to make sure that you are one of the best candidates, all right? To be the best candidate, you have to demonstrate that you have the skill set. So I would say, demonstrate that you have some skill sets. Show that you have made impact. If you have documents, attachments, pictures, videos that shows that you did this, please put it there. I always emphasize on metrics and statistics. I worked with 3 communities and empowered 500 young people who now have ripple effect on over 20 communities. Do you understand? That is numbers and impact. Emphasize metrics a lot in all of this essence. Let it show that you understand what you're saying, because when you put metrics, when you put statistics, when you put number, when you put data, it helps to tell the reviewer that you know exactly what you're saying. If you have pictures, if you have videos, and I suggest you do, because in my time, I had to compile pictures of my different projects that I did and attach it to the application, even if it wasn't requested, because my goal was to make sure that I could tell them that I can do this thing, all right? I had demonstrated that I could do it, right? So be sure to tell them that you're very competent at what you're doing, all right? Don't write too much. Don't be too generalistic. Go specifically to one thing and keep emphasizing it, all right? Extrapolate it. Talk about what you're doing, how you're doing it, what the effects are, all right? Talk about the impact it is making in the community. Talk about the specific skill set you have in that regard. If you're not sure the kind of skill sets that are in whatever it is that you're putting yourself, either as a project manager, as a communication expert, as an M&E expert, or as a tech expert, go online and read about the specific skill sets that come under this, you know, themes, under this categories, all right? And see how you can tell your story, how you can weave your answer around that. That way, you are in a better position to be more accepted, more because you're deliberate, you're professional, and you're very specific. So you would also need to talk about, okay, you would talk about that in some of the short essays, all right? The essays basically is just to see how you write, okay? Because the program is an English-speaking program, you would need to write very good English, all right? If you're not sure, please tell somebody to help you review your essays once you're done. I would suggest that you write with very clear, easy-to-read English, all right? Make sure your tenses are correct and your grammar is just on point. Because here, the people reviewing your applications are, as it were, English-speaking people, all right? You will have also to, you know, guest recommendation. I would say that the higher your recommendation, possibly, the better for you, okay? If it is from your boss that you worked with, beautiful. If it's from somebody that supervised you in a project, awesome. If it's, make sure the recommendation is in line with what you are writing. Whether it is, let the recommender emphasize that this guy, this girl, is an expert in this thing, okay? So the more you demonstrate the same thing you're saying, the better it for you. If you go for a job interview, apart from the fact that you have the attitude, you have the, they need to know that you can deliver on the job, okay? So that's why you have to emphasize on those parts. So the second part is really that simple, provide your recommenders. But there's one part I really want to share with us, and that has to do, if you scale through, this is now the third part, which is the interview process. The interview, most times, when you get to that level, you are actually very close to being selected, very close. And this interview is to know you. First tip for an interview, if it's a Skype interview, please, this worked for me, it might not work for everybody, dress formally, like you're going for an interview, okay? Dress well, have good lighting. Look at me now, I'm trying to do this, I had to get light everywhere just to make sure that I can communicate with you, okay? It was already getting dark while I was doing this video, so I had to get light just to put it on my face so that. Have very good lighting. Let your reviewer know that you're serious about this and you really want to succeed in it, okay? That's one. Secondly, don't underestimate the questions that can be asked. I will read out four questions that you are likely going to be asked, and I'll try to give you one or two tips around them. The first is, why do you want to be an Atlas Core Fellow? Why should you be considered for the Atlas Core Fellowship? It's really simple. You want to be an Atlas Core Fellow because you want to contribute. Very important. You want to contribute to developing the institution that you're going to be working with. One, you want to join a league or a network of social change makers who are already doing change in communities, in organizations, and you want to be part of that network of people, okay? Emphasize that. Also, emphasize in your application that the Atlas Core Fellowship is a very prestigious fellowship and a program, and you want to be part of those who will be solving complex problems for the world. Okay. So if you can show that you want to contribute, you want to be part of a network of people that are doing things, doing great things in their communities. The next one says, what stands you out? What skills do you have that stands you out from every other applicant? The same thing happens. Go back to your essay, read it well. But now, because you've written it, communicate it with so much passion and so much professionalism. Okay? I am good at this. I am a professional project manager. I worked on this project. This was what happened. This was how it happened. These were the process I used in making it happen. And this was the result. I had this number of success. I had this number of results. I had this number of outcome. I had a couple of challenges because you're human. And that shows that you're vulnerable, which is a very good thing. But I was able to overcome this because I knew how to do this out. For the few times I didn't get to, do this, I was able to speak to my supervisor, execute that project. My project currently is being nominated as one of this. I have this on the website, specify clearly that you're good at what you do. The third question says, maybe give us an example of the time where you experience workplace conflict, either with your team or colleagues, and how you're able to navigate such situation. So what I would say here is, they just want to know if you're very good, if you're able to handle conflict. It's really obvious, but more, it has to do with diplomacy, okay? How diplomatic are you with issues? How are you able to resolve issues quickly? It's better to be part of the solution than to be part of the problem. So what I would say here is, show to them how, in the course of doing your work, you experienced the conflicting situation. It could be amongst in your role, maybe a particular job you're doing, and you had a conflict of interest with your boss, or you had a particular project and there's a conflict of interest with maybe a partnering organization. How did you handle it? All right. State a case in point. Tell them how you resolved it. Tell them what the results were. And that way, you're communicating that you're very good at managing conflicts, basically. That's it. Then, giving it an example of a time when in your professional career you had to develop personal and community relationships and how you were able to go about this. So this is about interpersonal relationships. If you are finally selected as an Atlas Core Fellow, you would have to learn how to connect with the American people. The American people have their specific kind of values and specific kind of culture. You would have to learn that. So there is nothing bad with being in a new place, but not having the right attitude could be a problem, all right? So what they're asking for here is this. How are you able to relate with people on a professional and on a personal level? Because these two things matter a lot. If you're able to relate to people on a personal level and you're cordial with people and you understand people, that is a good thing. Tell them how you're doing. It could be that you have the gift of empathy, or you have the skill of empathy. You can relate with people because you know where they're coming from. One could be that you're a very good listener. One could be that you understand people's culture. I would even say that you are somebody who is very adaptable. You can adapt to new culture. And when you get to new places, you are able to quickly adapt into that. Concluding with the last question, which talks about culture shock. So they will ask you questions around if you've ever experienced culture shock, or if you have to experience culture shock, how would you cope with it? All right? And this in itself is a very important question. When I first came to the state, I had my culture shock. Anybody who comes to the US for the first time, or to a new environment, or to a new place, they always experience culture shock. So the thing you want to quickly emphasize is, talk about adaptability. Adaptability is one thing we all have as human beings. You just want to emphasize that you can adapt. And how are you able to adapt? You would learn the culture of the people. Guys, I think that's like basically all the things that I need to talk about. I know that I might not be answering everybody's specific question. As you know, this is like my debut project and my debut talk. I want you to please, if you have any questions, write it at the comment section of this channel. I'm starting this project because I want to be sharing information to people. I want to be sharing opportunities, sharing tools that will help especially young people succeed, both in the local and the global environment. The nonprofit sector is huge. The development sector is huge. And even this is a season where there are lots of applications. So I'll be sharing a lot of tips on this channel. spread this word out there to everybody who wants to apply first. Global opportunities, scholarships, fellowships, you will be getting them. If you find this very useful, please share with friends. And if you share with friends, I'm sure friends will also share with friends. All right, cheers, guys, and have a wonderful week.